We're in downtown Los Barriles, and this is Smokey's. This is where, when you bring fish in from a day of fishing, you're gonna want them processed, either frozen or smoked, but packaged up nice so you can take some fish home, like tuna and dorado and whatever. But Smokey's is the place that Palmas de Cortez uses to process the fish, so all your fish is brought here. And it's also a really good restaurant, probably the most popular place in town. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take you inside where Chris, the owner, is going to show you exactly how the fish is handled and processed. It's a really great operation. And so if you come down here, this is a place where you can bring some fish back. And the reason that you can do that is that there's a place like this that exists, because without something like this, it would be a little difficult to get your good quality fish home. So let's go inside.
Hi, I'm Chris, and we're gonna show you today how we process fish here in the East Cape. So what we do is we're down at, say, the Van Warmer Resorts docks, and guys come in and bring their catch in whole to the docks. So my crew will take the fish whole off the docks. We have a cutting room nearby. We take the fish to the cutting room, fillet it, label it, put it on ice, and then at the end of the day, we bring all the fish here, back here to manicure, and either smoke and package or vac seal and flash freeze. So the fish will come in back here, and our crew will, as I said, manicure it and sanitize it in a salt ice brine. And so it's naturally sanitized. And then what we'll do is we'll rinse it, and we'll come back, we'll bag it over here. We use very high quality 5 mil bags. 5 mil bags to seal the fish in. So we'll come back here, and we'll seal it in this machine or one of our two machines. And so that's what we'll do for the fresh, and we'll flash freeze it. Let me show you the freezer. If the customer wants the fish fresh, we'll come and we'll put it in these boxes here, label it all, and throw it in the freezer where it'll be frozen the same night. And so the client's name never leaves the fish from the time on the dock to the time they pick it up. Now, if they want to smoke it, I'll show you what we do. We're gonna brine it the next day. I'll take you back here real quick again. So what we'll do is we'll brine it in a sea salt, brown sugar, and honey mix. And the length of time it's brined depends upon the species and the thickness. So like tuna, a bigger piece of dorado, yellowtail, we'll brine for a longer time. And stuff like Sierra or small thin species, fillets, we'll brine for shorter time. So we have that all down to a science. And then once it, tia, ya tenemos pescado para brine? So then what we'll do is we'll put the fish on racks and we'll dry it overnight to be smoked the next day. We smoked today, so our crews haven't come in and cleaned the grills yet, but we smoked earlier today, and that fish then gets packaged. The smoked fish gets packaged and saved for the client. So they'll come pick up their fish, either smoked or fresh or a combination of both. And then we'll package it up. I'll show you really quick. Let's go in here. We have airline approved. First let me show you this. Let me show you. So here's our smoker. As far as I'm concerned, Viropack makes the best smokers in the world. So this is, we can fit about 600 pounds in this on those racks at the most. And we'll throw it in here. There's one of our racks right there. Our process, from the time it's in the oven to the time it comes out, it's about 4.5 hours. So I want to go into a little bit more detail about our brine. So what we do with our brine is we mix a sea salt, brown sugar, and honey in bins, brining bins. And so it's all the same brine. And then what we do is we place the different species of fish per client in smaller bins, and we put the brine with the fish. And what we'll do is we'll put a tag on it saying how long we want to brine it. So the fish may be brined anywhere from 15 to 20 minutes to say an hour and a half. It's all based upon thickness. So what they'll do is obviously they'll have all the fish lined up, and the fish that's going to be brined an hour and a half, they'll put it in and everything's on a timer. They'll put the brine in that one and then say it's going to be an hour and 15 minutes. then that fish gets the brine. So it's designed so that the fish all comes out of the brine at the same time. So obviously, if there's something that's gonna be brined for 15 or 20 minutes, we'll put that brine in last, so it's all done at the same time. So what it's done is it's drained, and then it's placed on our oven racks, which are right here. This is the truck minus the racks. So just picture oven racks. And then what we'll do is we'll wheel this into the walk-in cooler where it stays overnight. And what that does is it's curing and drying the fish and getting it ready for the smoking process. So what you're looking for is called the pellicle. In the morning, you wanna go and you wanna touch if you touch the fish and it's tacky, or anything that you're gonna be smoking, if it's tacky, it's ready. And so generally overnight, we'll brine it and it's in that cooler and it's perfectly dried and ready for accepting smoke. So that's the process we use. And then I'll show you this right here. This is our smoke generator. So what happens here is this is where the wood is, and this is an auger that turns the wood down on a hot plate down here, and that generates smoke, and it takes it from here up to the smoker. Our tube is being cleaned right now, but generally, if you can picture like a water pipe, see there's a water baffle back here, so it's taking the smoke, filtering it through the water, so it's kind of like a water pipe, and it so all the ashes stay in the water. You get pure smoke up top, and this mixture of sawdust we have developed, it's a mixture of hickory and sugar maple. So we've developed that over the course of time. We find it just to be spectacular for fish. We have other kinds of wood that we use for different kind of meats and stuff like that, like apple and cherry and oak. But I mean, for the fish, it's sugar maple and hickory mix. A lot of people use alder. It's hard for us to get down here. So we found that mixture, and it's not half and half, I'm not gonna tell you exactly what it is, but it's a mixture of sugar maple and hickory that we've developed that's excellent for fish. Anyway, we'll package up all the fish, and we keep all the fish for the client may be here for a week or whatever. So we keep the fish the whole time until they're ready to leave. When they come in, we have these airline approved boxes. So we'll go, this will hold about 18 pounds, and this one here, we can fit 48 pounds of fish in this full, and it'll still be at 50 pounds for the airline. They don't want you to be over 50. So we've been doing it since about 96, and going strong. Opened up the restaurant, and it's fun. We have a good time.